Hey guys, Queen Nija here. So BTW for the episodes of Saki Part 3 Nationals, specifically 5 and 6. I was on episode 5, I was about 16 minutes in when my mom called me. So I had to stop it and then I resumed from where I left off. So I did have to cut it, unfortunately. It's still all going to be one video for you guys. So just so you know, if you're like, what the heck is going on? And why is it like this? Just know that at the 1632 minute mark, I stop, I get up to go. And then of course, at the same point, I will continue on when I get back. So yeah, if you have any other questions about it, you can go ahead and ask me. Of course, Patreons can ask me ASAP when this comes out Saturday. Everybody else can ask me on Monday when this comes out and such. But I'm sorry. She really needed me in that moment. Even though in the video I looked really pissed because I don't like when people interrupt me while I'm watching stuff and then I have to like somewhat restart it all over again. But she was really going through something and she just really needed my support at that moment. She's okay now, but what she's thinking about, towards certain opportunities and stuff, I think she got really in her head and she started to cry and she just needed someone, like a shoulder to cry on and such. But she's okay. But that's all I wanted to say. Enjoy the videos and I will see you guys all next time. Bye. Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting for you to episodes 5 and 6 of Saki the Nationals, part 3. So let's go ahead and get started with episode 5 in 3, 2, 1. You would go off again! Oh my god! Take 2 in 3, 2, 1. Go. Motion detected at the front door. Will you shut up? One more. One more. Oh my god. There's no one at the front door. They're just talking. Shut up. Shut up. But wouldn't it be a good opportunity for you? That is some shade. Oh my God. Aw. No, that's our ability. No. It's okay. Be proud about that. Well, not only her. About to say. Oh to get up. Come here. Well, damn, she did that for all four that quickly? Sorry about that slight little mishap. My mom needed my assistance real quick. So we are continuing from the 16.32 minute in three, hold on, three, two, one, go. Mavilano. And what do you have? Good, Jesus. I just want the dang cookie. Basically. Poor thing is getting farther away from her and she wouldn't be able to get it. Of course, Mako. Yeah, didn't envision that. Wow. About the fact that she's still sleeping. Okay, the girl from New England, no, New Zealand, her method was very interesting, different. I mean, because, like, when we compare each and every single girl's method and how they essentially play, everybody's different. There is no other character that is, like, a one-to-one same. I do like how with her, she had different outcomes, and if it wasn't a certain way, she would go back, rethink it or reevaluate it, and bring it back in. But Mako, glasses on, glasses off, still upstaged her. So, congratulations to Mako, she did great. I'm happy. Honestly, this was a really good episode, even with the despite the situation of what just happened a couple of minutes ago. But I'm okay. I hate the fact that, you know, the princess, when her situation starts and how she goes to sleep for a limited time. So, you know, well, that's sad because I'm not gonna hear Saudi Haimi, but it's okay. Well, that's embarrassing. I mean, at least she knows. It also makes me hungry, even though I'm eating Milano cookies. But I want food, food. Cookies are just like a little staple-esque. I want food. But seriously, no, this is a really interesting episode. This match was definitely something. I mean, starting how it started with, you know, Yuki, you know, upset. Still doing her best. She tried her best as she could, but truly upset. And then Mako was just like, you know, I'm gonna get those points back. And she did, really. And I'm super duper proud of her for doing that. It takes a lot. I can't imagine, like, being in any sort of, like, game team com whatever, and you mess up and you're super duper so effing sad about that, and everybody's like, no, it's okay, it's okay. But in deep inside you're like, no, it's not, it's not, I fucked up, like I really fucked up. But gotta pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for episode 6. Alrighty, episode 6 in 3, 2, 1, go. It don't look good. Look at the rice. It's okay. You tried your best. Baby. Oh. No. I wonder still if she's ever gonna wake up. I mean, Jesus. Already. You got this. Ooh. Maybe because the other three's auras. You gotta drown out their voices. That's what's screwing you over. Excuse me. They is towering over you, babe. There we go. She'll be fine. Oh. She's right. Yeah, but I think she's doing that for a reason. She has a plan. Damn, okay, so that's how we end in this match. Hopefully. To have a moment in the first half. She'll find a way. She's more relaxed now and fired up. She's still going. Oh my God. Coming back. All right, now since Captain is finally back in this, we pray she wins this. We don't need them to get off and lose and get eliminated, hopefully. But yeah, I mean, I was a little afraid too. She definitely was off her game in the first half, and she did collect herself back in the last couple parts of the first half. But in the next two episodes, aka this was 5 and 6, so 7 and 8, hopefully, we get good news. All I'm praying for. But I mean, you know, once again, Nationals is a big freaking deal. Everyone who goes in, they are the top of the top. You know why they're there, what they're planning to do. And these girls are tough. These girls are not going to back down without a fight. And it's crazy. I mean, I couldn't do it. But seriously, this was super sweet and such. We hope and pray it happens, that she wins, and that the girls can move on. That's all I care about. But yeah, these two episodes are very interesting. Different in the way and shape and form of what happened, but still interesting at the most. But I am glad that everything of what did happen, we got a solution for it. Captain is back on her A game. Everybody's okay with her now. Yes, some people are be like, hey, yo, she got to last in the first half. She might end up really losing this and costing them everything. And even if they did, I mean, I think they would still be, Saki and them would be fine with it. But their other friends, for an example, definitely would be like, hey, y'all need a stern talking to. Be like, what the heck was that? You promised us a bomb good behind match, and then look what happened. What happened? Where did it all go wrong? But that's something that we all definitely want to know. But it was still good as hell. But other than that, guys, that's my action view towards episodes 5 and 6 of Saki the Nationals Part 3. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Metro Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons and next Monday for everybody else for episodes 7 and 8. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.